Hi, and welcome to another video by the Writing and Tutoring Center. This video is going to be about the conversion of square and cubic units. For the purposes of this video, I'm going to assume that you're already familiar with how to convert ordinary units, and I'm just going to run through that method really quickly. So an ordinary unit conversion, for example, from inches to feet would look somewhat like this. We have, for example, 18 inches. We need a conversion factor, which I'm going to represent by a fraction, and I'm going to put it in a parenthesis. This is multiplied. We want the inches to cancel, and we want the feet to reappear. So now we really just have to figure out how do we make this entire factor be equal to 1, so we don't actually change anything about the amount of things we have here. So we happen to know in this case that 12 inches are equal to 1 foot. And then we basically just go through and cancel the units here. 18 divided by 12 is 1.5, and we're left with 1.5 feet. That's how we usually do it. Now the big question is, what do we do if those units are not to the first order, but they're squared or cubed? Let's see for the cubed example. What if we want to go from inches cubed to cubic feet? Now, we can kind of try to figure out on our own, just doing the brute force method, basically like we did it before. So let's just see what happens if we try doing it like we did before. Let's say we have 120 cubic inches, and then we do the same thing as we did with a fraction, and we know that there are 12 inches, and that 12 inches is equal to 1 foot. Now you would be tempted to start canceling the inches here and cancel the inches here, but I'm just going to rewrite this real quick to show you why that's not quite possible. We have 120 cubic inches, so that's basically the same as having inches multiplied by inches multiplied by inches. So if we then have that conversion factor of 1 foot over 12 inches, we're really only canceling out 1 of the inches, and we get this really weird thing where we get 10, which is 120 divided by 12, 10 inches squared and a foot. So that doesn't quite seem right. But it also kind of hints at what we really have to do. And that's the key to converting square and cubic units. We need to cancel this cubic unit out 3 times. So we have to cancel the inches for all the 3 times that it's there. Basically, the way we do that is we can rewrite it here as the cubic unit, and then we take the conversion factor we know, which is that 12 inches equal a foot, and we do that 3 times. The second time here, and then we multiply again, 1 foot over 12 inches. And we can basically summarize that by restating it as 120 cubic inches, and then our conversion factor, and that entire factor is cubed because our original unit was also cubed. And then we can see what happens. Basically, this then turns into this here, where we have the cubic inches, and we have to cube the 1 here, but 1 cubed is just 1, so we can leave that. Then we have to cube the feet, so we get feet cubed. We have to cube the 12, and we have to cube the inches. So in essence, what you see is that the cube up here distributes to each one of the terms in the parentheses, as it should. And then basically it just becomes a task for the calculator. We have 120 divided by 12 cubed. Our inches cancel completely, and we are left with cubic feet in terms of an actual decimal number. That turns into 0.0694 cubic feet, which is, of course, very different from 10. So basically, what you need to look out for is what is the power of my units? And then you take your conversion factor and raise it to that same power. Now let's see how that looks when we're dealing with a square unit. It's the same principle again. So let's say we have cubic centimeters, and we want to take that to cubic inches. And we're given, let's say, 100 square centimeters. And we know the conversion factor in this case, either because we just happen to know it or because we can look it up. And there are 2.54 centimeters for every 1 inch. That is our conversion factor. And because we have that square power on our unit, we have to square our conversion factor as well. And just like before, our square distributes to each term. So 1 squared is still 1. We get inches squared over 2.54 squared as well, and centimeters squared, which tells us that the centimeters actually cancel here. The inches remain, and if we put those numbers in the calculator, in this case 100 divided by 2.54 cubed, it comes out to roughly 15.5 inches cubed. All right, I hope that helps you in your conversion of square and cubic units.